welcome to another episode of WCW Nitro. Before we get into tonight's event, got some major news to announce that's going to shake the foundation of WWE and WCW. Due to poor ratings and lack of interest, WWE Speed has been scrapped. With increased roster from the AEW acquisition, NXT is returning to replace WWE Speed. Both champions in Speed, Robert Roode and Cora Jade, will have first rights to compete for the vacant NXT championships. Four PLE events are scheduled for NXT within the next calendar year. Those events will be announced shortly. Updated rosters will also be finalized and announced shortly. The 24/7 championship has been reinstated and will be competed on both Raw and SmackDown. And WWE management is looking into reinstating the WWE Women's Tag Team Championship. And our first match for tonight, we got Nathan Frazer taking on Rey Mysterio Jr. with his son, Dominic, showing up and in his corner. Should be a good one.
Skills in winning the NXT Heritage Cup. A truly well-rounded athlete.
Nathan Frazer, the young high flyer, ready to get this thing going here.
Daredevil ways, fearless attitude. Frazer is the real deal. We've never seen him give anything less than his all in the ring. And tonight should be no different.
Absolutely, Byron. This young man is all about pushing the limits, going all out every time that bell rings.
And opposite him is a true legend in Rey Mysterio.
They simply do not make him like Rey Mysterio anymore.
Goes into the pin.
Just kicking out at one takes a lot in a match like this.
Oh, round and round we go. Tilt-a-whirl head scissors.
into the corner.
Big stomp in the corner, creating a lot of separation.
What execution, but I don't know who's left worse for wear.
Ridiculous standing shooting star.
You have solidified your name as a top athlete when you're able to pull off that move.
If you're taking on Rey Mysterio, there's one key strategy. Never underestimate him. Even when you think you have the advantage, when you think you have him beat, Mysterio can instantly flip the script and take over a match.
That ability to turn things around has served Rey well over the years. Definitely something to watch out for as his opponent. Rey just can't stop this attack.
I like this. Never underestimating Mysterio. Trying to put Rey on his back foot and keep him there.
Into the cover.
A penny predicament, but it really doesn't matter.
Drops the hammer.
Right on the lower back. Got the knees up. Mysterio is going to look to press on the advantage.
Exactly what Rey needed to get out of trouble.
Oh, my God.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
Setting them up.
Seeing that from Mysterio never gets old.
When Rey's dialed in like that, you know he's got one thing in mind.
Brought back into the ring from the floor now. And wait a minute. What's the manager doing under the apron?
Wait a minute. Something's going on here. The lights have gone out again. All of a sudden, there's a loud crack. The lights come back on and Rey is down. Nathan Frazier's down and Dom is standing in the middle of the ring looking down at his father with a chair laying on the ground behind him. Dominic leans down, says something to his father and then punches him in the face repeatedly as the referees break it up and pull him off his father. Rey is busted open. Fans are going nuts. They can't believe what they just saw. As Dominic Mysterio comes to WCW, faking everybody out, thinking that he was going to patch things up with his father, when in reality, he's continuing the war. Coming up next, Bayley taking on Tegan Knox as Damage Control is coming ringside alongside Bayley. That match, it's next.
Tegan Knox looking ready for a fight. Yeah, she wants to show this crowd what she can do.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring from the Welsh Valleys, Tegan Knox.
Behind the smiles of Tegan Knox is a surprising toughness.
Yeah, what's impressive is that despite taking hits and suffering devastating injuries, they haven't discouraged Knox.
A feel-good story every time Tegan Knox competes.
And here come three women looking to take control.
Perhaps the most dominant women's faction in WWE history.
And representing Damage Control from San Jose, California, Bayley.
Attitude or not, you cannot deny the collective talent of Bayley, Dakota Kai, and Io Sky.
Io Sky, maybe the best high flyer in women's division history. Kai, one of the most lethal strikers around, all led by the genius level ring IQ of the role model.
Yeah, here's the thing, they've also won roughshod over the entire women's division. Heck, they've even brought the fight to legends like Trish Stratus and Lita.
That's because nobody stands in the way of Damage Control.
dominance, thy name is Damage Control.
Tegan Knox is someone to really admire. She's got that hunger, that drive that you really need in this business. She's always willing to put everything she has into this, and that really shines through in her matches.
That drive of Knox could really serve her well here in this match.
And then we have Bayley. Lover or hater, there's no denying Bayley's a trailblazer. She's had so many iconic, first-of-their-kind matches. She's made a career of making history.
Yeah, putting her personality and antics aside, Bayley has accomplished some astonishing things. And I know she's got big aspirations of even greater heights to come.
I think rage took over in that moment. Nothing but blind rage. Tossed into the corner.
Focusing on them.
Can she do it here? And a shoulder in the air.
Staying in this one. So much damage inflicted.
Off the ropes.
What the heck is this manager doing looking out of the ring? She can't be acting like this. Heads out of the ring. What's next? Snap suplex. Oh, that backfired on her. Boom, what an uppercut.
Jarring.
Bayley combats out of that. Ah, oh, look at this. Hair-pulled mat slam. Obviously, Bayley has been in some very intense matches over the years. Corey, think her veteran know-how could give her the edge tonight?
Yeah, I would think so, Cole. Bayley's developed very keen instincts over the course of her career. If she trusts those instincts and lets her experience inform her attacks, I think it'll do wonders for her here.
Bayley's not looking so confident after taking that attack.
And that's Tegan's aggression starting to ratchet up.
Pretty drop kick.
Would you look at this? She is removing the turnbuckle pad now.
Oh, weakening the leg here.
From up high.
Quick thinking pays off.
Bayley's got it hooked.
Raising the arm before one.
An almost instantaneous kick out there. A lot of work left to do.
Bayley from behind, kick to the knee.
Spiked with the rose plant.
Is Bayley closing this out?
Two. Finally over.
Here is your winner.
Over Tegan Knox here.
Tegan Knox has been knocked down before, but don't forget, she always finds a way to get up and come back for more.
Backstage, Sean Jr. walks up to Dijak and Blair Davenport, who are standing talking about their latest woes and trials and tribulations. Sean says he enjoys watching them compete, loves their attitude and their potential. Says that if they stick with him, they will see the ways of the business, the real truths, lies, and how the system is a farce. He says if they want to go to the top, come with him. He smiles as he walks away. Dijak and Blair both glance at each other and then proceed to follow Sean Jr. Coming up next, we have a X Division title match. Noam Dar taking on Austin Theory. That match right now.
The following contest is an Extreme Rules match and is for the WCW Extreme Championship.
challenge you to find a more impressive young talent.
Very skilled, but also very arrogant.
It up every night.
Stay at those heights, or will he crash back down to earth?
Big match here, guys, as the title will be on the line tonight.
And the champ has looked dominant of late, but all it takes is one wrong move, and that title could be going home with somebody else.
It's a true test for this guy. Austin Theory is a complete package of speed, athleticism, and strength.
The champion has no intention on tonight being their final night with the title.
After winning this title, the champion seems to be riding high.
Any champion's riding high. Cole, what do you want him to skulk around, bum that they're the best?
That's not what I meant. Forget it. And that point for a pin for the championship. Barely kicks out.
Close call. That was almost lights out.
Solid punch.
Gentlemen, this is what I believe we refer to as mud hole stomping.
If you needed evidence of how much that championship means, look no further than that onslaught.
Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off.
Elbow drop. Oh, new champ. He narrowly avoids the count.
You have to think this battle is starting to weigh down on him.
Scoop slam, making it look easy.
And he has free reign to the outside with no countouts to worry about.
Bringing a steel chair into play here.
Just a continuous rush on Noam Dar here.
Theory is doing the job of breaking the opposition down.
We've seen the length superstars are willing to go to in an Extreme Rules match to earn the victory. What do you have to do to get yourself in that mindset?
Well, it's all about adapting in Extreme Rules. You really have to be creative and maybe even a little crazy if you want to succeed.
The table, the WWE Universe is going wild.
Oh, look at the torch of their opponent.
Uh-oh, this isn't going to be good.
Oh, man. And gets tossed back into the mat. He's setting it up on the ring apron right now.
You've got to wonder what he has in mind here.
And he goes into the ring.
Oh, man, drop kick.
Trying to debilitate the capability to stand. A sound suplex. And suplex.
And he heads out of the ring. No countouts, no worries. Getting back into the ring. Oh, what impact.
Punch right in the head.
Theory sidesteps.
He got whipped into that corner.
He's turning the tables.
Takedown. Helicopter spin.
This is ridiculous. This is insulting.
This is a
chance. Got the pin to retain. An early kick out for the challenger.
Just using the adrenaline to stay in the match. We're no closer to a winner just yet.
Oh, one elbow high on the chin. Oh, stop right to the hand.
I love the champion's mindset here. Nothing fancy, just trying to deal out as much damage as possible.
Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here? Oh, man, come on now. Not a sledgehammer.
He's heading back to the ring. Oh, right to the back. Oh, and a stop.
Noam Dar with the upper hand.
Can Theory ride out this outpouring?
Him up on that ladder now.
I cannot imagine what he's got in store next.
He's stalking his opponent from the top turnbuckle. Comes back into the ring.
The Scottish Supernova looking more like a surgeon.
Noam Dar is so...
Beautiful takedown into the Achilles lock. What a unique submission maneuver here. Look at the pain his opponent's in.
How much punishment?
Hey, watch this. Letting him free?
Had him where he wanted him, but maybe he has something better planned.
Rolling outside, and he's looking like he wants nothing to do with it.
And he'll leave the ring for this next stretch.
Up across the shoulders.
TKO. Ooh, what a nasty kick. Just disrespectful.
They are feeding off the WWE fans, now pinning the arm down, and
goodness gracious.
The effects of this match are showing on the champ.
Yeah, Theory's showing he's wise beyond his years with that offensive display.
Looking to do a little clanging and banging with that.
No. Oh, no. Crashing hard onto the floor.
Face meet floor.
I think I see a few teeth on the floor.
He climbs into the ring.
Oh, disturbing impact.
The champ is down. Title change. I can feel it.
He got the shoulder up in time.
I can't believe it. He just won't go away.
Measuring. Oh, face stomp.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
Noam Dar is just getting knocked away.
Theory with a kick to the midsection. Tying his opponent up.
Gonna see a new champ. Is it enough? The cover. Two.
Austin Theory just etched his name in the history books tonight.
Here is your winner. And new WCW Extreme Champion, Austin.
So Noam Dar's reign as X Division champ comes to an end, a very quick end. We'll see if he invokes his rematch clause as Austin Theory takes the belt off him and now begins a second run as champion in WCW. Coming up next, Piper Niven taking on WCW Hall of Famer and icon Stacy Keibler.
The Scottish powerhouse of the women's division.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring, representing Havoc, from Ayrshire, Scotland, Piper Niven.
Niven has made it very clear as of late, whatever she wants, she will take.
You're not kidding, Saxton. She basically declared herself a tag team champion. And the funny part was, nobody objected.
Piper Niven looking to make a name for herself tonight.
From Nitro Girl, the manager, to one of the best competitors in women's division history.
Just as lethal as she is lovely.
And from Baltimore, Maryland, Stacy Keibler.
She repped the NWO Wolfpack as a fan, won a contest to become a WCW Nitro Girl, and is now a top name in WWE's women's division.
A beloved competitor, respected manager, and one of the most entertaining competitors around. Hey, Stacy.
One of the most successful competitors in women's division history.
The entire women's division looking to make their name at the expense of Stacy Keibler.
We're about to witness the terrifying strength of Piper Niven.
Few superstars in WWE can match that power, and I don't know if there's anyone who can beat her impactful arsenal. When Piper steps between those ropes, there's little to no hope of stopping her.
She looks very determined to prove just that here tonight.
And standing across the ring from her is a legitimate legend in WWE. One of the craftiest superstars to ever step foot in the ring, Stacy Keibler.
Talk about someone who never ceases to surprise. Stacy is as smart of a competitor as they come, somehow always finding ways to win.
And now thrown back into the ring.
And here we go now.
Elbow drop to the knee.
Debilitating attack on the leg.
Grabs the leg.
The old leg toss.
Really challenging Keibler with that.
Yeah, Piper Niven was channeling that ruthless aggression, just dominating the competition there.
The Scottish powerhouse, Piper Niven. We already know what she needs to do in this one. Unleash that power. Unleash that ruthless aggression. Unleash the real Piper Niven.
Uh-oh, jawbreaker!
Call the dentist.
Ouch, caught her.
clothesline out of nowhere.
Incoming.
Crash landing. Powerbomb. That was one of those powerbombs that would shorten someone's career.
Crushing the knee there.
That could be it.
And a kick out before even one there.
She shows that she's far from finished.
Shoot, slam into the ropes.
Man.
And now she's climbing to the top turnbuckle.
Leave a mark.
No, no, no. Oh, ouch!
Ripped in the hard way.
She's lost some of that energy she had earlier.
And hanging tough, but beginning to show some wear and tear. Might want to think about picking up the pace a bit. And Stacy escapes danger.
Running clothesline.
Oh. And Stacy taking advantage of the opportune moment.
Oh, man, a back break.
Gross. How dirty is that?
Northern Lights. And shoulders are down. Two count. She was close to the end there. Wow.
And Niven is showboating right now.
Uh-oh, this is not going to end well. Crash landing, powerbomb.
A powerbomb's not meant to be pretty, but oh, man, does it get the job done.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they don't want to be taking any more of those.
A little rope assistance, punishing their opponent.
Ooh, accurate roundhouse.
Stacy about to end this fight. Makes the cover. No, she kicked out.
Oh, I thought that was game over.
Pure guts to kick out there. Confidence must be waning as she hits the opposition hard, but still can't get the fall.
Well, that's how you dominate your opponent.
Oh, torturous knee.
Right across the knee, heel hook locked in. This is painful.
And an overbearing amount of offense against Niven here.
We're seeing a smothering offense from Stacy here.
Quick thinking from Piper.
At last, Piper keeping that string of offense in check.
Could be a chance for Niven to change the complexion.
Something in store for Keebler.
Tonight.
Here is your winner, Piper Niven.
An impactful victory for Piper Niven here.
My gosh, this has to be a terrible loss for Stacy Keebler.
Respect her desire to compete, but Stacy's legs nor her will to win were enough tonight.
So a great match between Piper Niven and Stacy Keebler, but the powerhouse Piper Niven wins the match and moves on. Coming up next, Dijak teams up with Sean Jr. to take on Carmelo Hayes and the Power of Tazawa. That match is next.
This is gonna be good.
The following is a Tornado Tag Team match. On the way to the ring, accompanied by Blair Davenport, at a combined weight of 540 pounds.
Okay, I created their entrance. I do not know why it's doing this. This game is so freaking flawed, it's not funny.
Sean Jr.
I'm going to tell you why I don't like this game sometimes. So I got the card for this show created last night. Today is May 21st, so I did this card last night, 5:20. I set it up, and I saved it, and I exited out of the game. I come back, and it's all completely effed up. What's the point of saving if it doesn't keep it? And I created this tag team and their entrance. I worked on their entrance in the creation mode, but for some reason, it doesn't take it from there to Universe. You actually have to go in through Universe to fix it, and for some stupid reason it's not working. That entrance, I did not create that, so I don't get that. They need to fix this game and its flaws big time.
Superstar to watch between the ropes. Nobody does it better, at least according to him.
Well, I fail to see how anyone could disagree.
Hayes has ridiculous athleticism and a skill ceiling that's only getting higher.
It's gonna be fun, because here comes the Ninja Master, the master of martial arts.
And representing the Alpha Academy from Kobe, Japan, weighing in at 156 pounds, Akira Tozawa.
Akira Tozawa, so explosive inside the ring.
Yeah, he possesses one of the best German suplexes you'll ever see. Tozawa hits hard and fast.
As high intensity as they come.
Well, you know, when Tozawa's inside the ring, he is often full of surprises.
Expect the unexpected with Akira Tozawa.
Is going to be searching for a tag in this one, guys.
Everybody is legal at all times, which sets up a recipe for destruction.
Oh, an inverted DDT.
Ooh. What a clothesline. Lands the knee. From behind, back suplex.
Well-placed kick.
Facebuster.
Firm control.
Oh, foot meet face.
Put you our armbar applied.
Getting the upper hand by taking away your opponents. Stomp in the leg.
Hurricane Rana
makes the cover. And he breaks the count quickly.
These men knew this match was going to be hard fought.
Something's in store for him.
He's got him down. Is this it? Getting the shoulder up before two.
Keeping a loss at bay for now.
He was waiting for him to make his move.
Rolling neck snap.
Come on now. What is this manager bringing out? He should revoke his license for this. Measuring. Oof. Face stomp. Getting tossed by the Hurricane Rana. And a Oof. Stomp to the gut, too.
It's cinched in. This could be.
We're going to free the arm and does just that.
Neckbreaker.
Ouch. Getting carried around. Bad spot to be in.
Ooh, nasty shot to him.
Here's the cover. before two.
Frankly, he should have known that wasn't enough.
Right to the kidneys from behind. Neckbreaker! Kick to the midsection. Setting them up.
There's the Canadian Destroyer.
Wow.
So resilient.
Oh, what a knee strike. Akira Tozawa planted one that,
no way.
Tozawa is just handing it up to the crowd. A bit too much hot dogging, if you ask me.
That catches Tozawa looking.
Both knees into the face. And the confidence and cockiness of Hayes.
Uh-oh, he could be looking for a submission here. Abdominal stretch.
Fighting it.
That's one way to get out.
Tozawa able to avert that. Uh-oh.
High justice.
Tozawa looks out of it.
And there's the save.
And this might not have a pleasant ending. Fights out of trouble with a barrage of strikes.
Heading back to the ring.
Oh, my! He's got him here. He's got him up.
And, oh, she has bad intentions now. Removing the turnbuckle pad.
Oh, God. This match's brutality starting to show on him. And look at this now. Bad intentions coming with his hole. We're on his stomach. Busted crab. Busted crab.
He is in serious trouble here and finds his way out.
Leg sweep. Look out. Oh, the high risk doesn't pay off.
Tempted fate and paid dearly for it.
That haphazard approach definitely proved costly.
He returns to the ring.
Big boot.
Vicious right forearm.
Would you are armbar apply?
Ooh,
cover. Is it enough? And a quick kick out.
How on earth could he not keep him down for even one at this point?
Oh, look at this arm wrench.
Leg lariat with the arm wrench. Very nice.
Some kind of neck breaker. Very effective.
Watch out.
That is reckless abandon being shown.
And paying off as well.
Boom! What a whack! Tozawa manages the counter. Down across the neck.
Quick strike to the lower body.
Oh, what a chop! And now tying up the leg.
Straight to the knee.
Big impact.
Up across the shoulders.
Into a sidewalk slam!
Wow.
Awesome!
This is his
cover!
Uh-oh! Justice has been served from Dijak!
Two! Barely kicks out!
Good lord, scarily close to three!
We have seen such a physical match from these combatants, and the wear and tear is starting to show.
And now the time where the smartest competitor needs to take advantage of the situation, needs to figure out the quickest way to end this.
Just punched him right in the mouth.
Relentless.
Enough already.
Just continuing to dismantle their opponent. Taking flight.
Body splash. Looking for the victory. You gotta believe that not wanting to feel the agony of defeat is causing this never surrender attitude. And listen to this place.
And what he's looking for here looks like a potential submission maneuver coming.
Going deep with that Boston Crab.
Look at the...
Whoa, look at that. And somehow he's able to work his way out of the holds. He could pin his opponent right here.
It's over.
Here are your winners, Sean Junior and
for one of the best teams around with that win.
This team was totally in sync, attacking in perfect unison like they were reading each other's minds.
It's scheduled for one fall, and it's for the WCW United States Championship!
Can you dig it?
The six times!
Saxton, we get it.
And he gets the finish, Corey!
Welcome home, Booker T. He is back in WCW, the five-time WCW champion.
Won over the WWE Universe with his somewhat unorthodox in-ring style and incomparable charisma.
But I'll tell you one thing, that WWE Universe can definitely dig it,
sucker.
Of course, Booker T, very familiar with the WCW US title, a title he's held multiple times.
Just exploded.
And he's got a chance to add it back into his repertoire once again, but it's going to be a tough task against MJF.
Champ is certainly going to have an uphill battle, that's for sure.
Introducing the challenger from Houston, Texas, weighing in at 251 pounds, Booker T. And his opponent from Long Island, New York, weighing in at 228 pounds, the WCW United States Champion, MJF.
You win this title, you are primed for big things.
And here we have a superstar who's been grinding his teeth at the Performance Center as of late.
Yeah, a consistent work ethic is what you're talking about, Michael. He's not someone who will rest on his laurels.
He never has been, and that dedication is what puts him in position to win tonight.
This is going to be great. I've been looking forward to this United States Championship match ever since it was announced.
Now, clothesline!
Placing them into the corner. Wicked clothesline.
Oof.
Front face lock applied. It's about to get more painful.
Oh, jeez.
Take all the wind out of you. Look out. Diving brain chop.
Very measured elbow drop.
Challenger's a little worse for wear now.
Hoisting their opponent.
Oh, fisherman's buster into the pin attempt.
And there's the kick out.
He clearly has no intention of staying down.
Elbow drop.
And Booker T getting worked on right now.
Can Booker withstand this surge against him?
Ooh.
Booker T is a hell of an athlete and a hell of a competitor. You have to think those two things are his keys to victory tonight, right, Corey?
Absolutely, Cole. Booker has an innate level of skill that gives him a leg up on most superstars. He does it
high risk.
Oh, the high risk doesn't pay off. Booker T with a well-timed shot.
I want to see him throw hands.
Big leg drop. Booker's attack gets reversed.
And down with the suplex.
He's on the ropes. The official sees it and waves off the pin. There!
That was vicious.
Lining Booker up.
Superstar's locked in.
And he makes it to the ropes.
I knew he could. Go for the arm bar and up.
Just stretching out the arm. The challenger's hopes are slipping away.
Yeah, this match has not been kind to him.
Booker T is getting taken out to the woodshed here.
Booker retaliates.
Drops the hammer.
Right on the lower back.
Going through the arena.
Uncorks a thunderous chop.
In the corner. Great counter. Impressive ring IQ on display there. Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
Incredible reversal into a DDT.
Taking the worst end of the exchange.
And some explosive offense from Booker T.
And face, shoulders down, championship on the line.
Brooke breaks the hold there.
And he wants nothing to do with any of that. Nice amateur takedown. All the way over.
Strapped.
Boom! But champions need to finish the job.
It was almost just lights out on their championship dreams.
Let's see if that kick out was a spark or is it the challenger's last gasp?
How draining was that? Can it be done again? Can that maneuver be summoned at least one more time? Caught with a lariat. Oh, look at the well-placed elbow right on the mark.
Kick to the midsection.
Booker T. Scissor kick.
We can have a new champion.
Good officiating there. Referee seeing him the ropes and breaking the count.
Ouch.
trampling the opposition.
The champ not in a great place.
At this stage of the match, they are clearly starting to feel the effects of this back and forth. The superstar is locked in.
He gets to the ropes. That's going to force the break.
Ooh. Oh, sharp knee. He fends off the attack.
Oh, flipping the script on him there.
Working on the leg.
Piercing.
Right to the chest.
Uh-oh, new champion. And referee cuts off the count in one.
Still gonna take a massive effort to keep him down.
Oh, reversal catches Booker T.
What a reversal by Booker.
Every maneuver being returned with counter fire. Suplex.
He is revving up the engine. He's not going to let anything stop him.
Into the ring now.
Oh, great display of strength with the suplex.
So much punishment has been absorbed by these men already.
And yet, they are still going, still ready for more. Oh, man! Trying to find his bearings, but it looks like his end is near.
Axeman for the win to retain the championship!
That's it! The champ stays the champ!
Big win as he retains the championship.
He came out here and defended what was his. You have to give him credit.
Main event time as we have a tornado tag team match. Scott Steiner teaming up with Drew McIntyre, taking on Eric Martin and the World Heavyweight Champion CM Punk. And that match is next.
The Scottish warrior, Drew McIntyre, has arrived. The fight is about to start.
We have learned that wherever McIntyre goes, brutality follows.
Right now, it is McIntyre who is leading the WWE Universe into battle.
Became WWE Champion.
Oh yeah, I am pumped for this guy.
And his partner from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 276 pounds, Big Otter Pump.
The WWE Universe more than ready to see this one start. This is gonna be good. A man who elevates his game every week. He is competing at his highest level yet.
comes the best in the world.
And he's not here to make friends. He's here to make money.
Forget the night of Punk's historic return. But now, Punk must prove himself.
Says he's now home, but many competitors have said this is no longer his home.
Punk has never been more focused. He's now down to business, and he wants to rewrite his legacy and write a whole new chapter in the WWE.
Punk's return was an amazing moment. But now, he must capitalize.
Yeah, easier said than done because the competition is now at an all-time high.
And the question remains, is being the best in the world still good enough?
Some would say the superstar thinks a little too much of themselves, but the tape doesn't lie. This is a serious contender for any title.
They need to loosen up, have a little fun, heck, maybe even lose a match once in a while.
What? That is horrible advice.
This is a match he's craved for quite some time. He's ready and raring to go.
And we have a tornado tag team match. Here's what that means. Everyone is legal and no tags are necessary.
What it means is we are all in for a hell of a brawl here.
Big clothesline. Ooh-hoo.
Wasting absolutely no respect on his opponent. You gotta love it.
Agility like
he thinks he has it.
And he manages to kick out at one.
Loose cover leads to a strong kick out.
Oh, look out!
It's gonna cost them.
Well, that was real.
Okay, so Drew goes flying out of the ring, crashes into Kelly. And we get DQ'd. Okay. Well, that's a great way to end the show. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you liked this episode, hit that like button. Leave a comment if you like. Subscribe to the channel. If you'd like to help out with future projects, upgrades to the channel, please visit my Patreon at patreon.com/mntwins28. Or you can drop something in the old Cash App. You don't have to help, but any help is always greatly appreciated. Until next time, peace out.